Good evening. This is a different start to our concert with me talking a bit, but this first piece that we're going to perform needs a bit of an introduction. As you can see on stage, it's a very different setup, and we need to explain a little bit about this piece to you before you experience it. So I have a couple notes from our composer, Michael Colgrass. He says, "A requiem is a dedication to the souls of the dead. Urban Requiem might be described as an urban tale, inspired by a diversity of random impressions. I thought of our urban areas, where the saxophone was spawned, and of the tragedies and struggles that occur in this environment daily. But I was also inspired by the energy and power of our cities, and the humor inherent in their conflicts. I feel that the saxophone is particularly well-suited to express the variety of emotions required for this idea, because it can not only be highly personal and poignant in character, but also powerful and commanding. In short, the saxophone is perhaps more like the human voice than any other instrument. It can howl like a banshee or purr like a kitten." And you'll hear both of those in this piece. "In my mind, I heard four saxophones singing like a vocal quartet, a music that was liturgical in nature, but with a bluesy overtone, a kind of after-hours requiem." So we feature four of our saxophonists here at UNF on this piece, and this piece has been dear to my heart since I first performed it at the University of Washington during my doctoral degree, and it has been an incredible experience to work on this piece. It's quite a long piece, so buckle in. For us, about 20, 25, 26, 27 minutes, depending on tempos. And it's going to take you through a lot of different emotions and a lot of different feelings. And as it is a requiem, I would like to dedicate it to some people in my life who have passed away in the last couple weeks, who have been important in three different circles, in the collegiate band world, in the world when I first became a band director as a middle school band director, and also in my family. So this is Urban Requiem, and I'd like to bring onto stage Gavin Martellotti, Kieran Ebwewan, and Jack Beatonhead, and Grayson Mills to perform Urban Requiem.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I am very fortunate here at UNF to work with many talented students, as you can hear. And every year we have a concerto competition for the UNF Wind Symphony. This is held in December, probably at a pretty busy time of year, but it seems like pretty much every month has a busy time too. And this year we had a real tough competition, but Natalia Garcia on clarinet came out with Black Dog, and it was such an impressive piece and an impressive performance that she won the concerto competition this year. And yesterday we had an event on campus for high school bands, and we had an opportunity to play for, well, an audience full of high school students, and I think she really inspired many young clarinetists yesterday. This piece is inspired by Led Zeppelin, and you're going to hear Natalia on her clarinet sounding a little bit like an electric guitar. Yes, a clarinet can sound like an electric guitar. So we hope you enjoy Black Dog, and we'll get Natalia Garcia out to perform with us. I bet you didn't know the clarinet could sound like that, right? Yeah. And this, I feel like, I hope, my hope is that you're being introduced to a lot of different sounds from the wind ensemble in this concert tonight. And this next piece, our final piece for tonight's performance, it brings in the world of the composer that he thought was not a part of the band world. And I think this is a really important idea for young composers today, that you need to be authentic to young musicians, you need to be authentic to yourself and to what type of music really gets to you and what's dope to you. So a little bit from Kataj Copley about this piece. He says, the first semester of my master's, he's still studying, he's a young guy, but this is a great piece. The first semester of my master's, I was in a different headspace. I had finished writing Where the Sky Has No Stars, and at the moment I felt renewed. I didn't know what else to write, so I began to write music that felt disingenuous to my spirit, music that will actually never see the light of day. I was going on autopilot, and I had lost my voice. During one of my lessons at UT Austin, my professor Omar Thomas and I began listening to a piece I had mocked up a couple days before. We both weren't feeling it, and I finally asked him to turn off the piece. And I told him it didn't sound like me. I felt that I'd lost creatively. He then asked me what music I listened to. I began to name only band composers. He asked me again, and I told him outside of wind band music, I'm in love with rap, R&B, jazz, and soul. Then he asked an important question. Why do you make a barrier between those ideals? I didn't have an answer. It was a wake-up call for me. Why was I compartmentalizing my musical inspirations? He continued, if you create something that is a celebration of who you are, the music you grew up with, and the music that inspires you now, then that would be dope. And with that, the piece was born. With the realization, I began to create a piece that celebrated all the music that had inspired me throughout my life. From Thundercat to Kendrick Lamar, Miles Davis, I wanted to bring all these influences together into one cohesive work, one dope work. Dope is a gumbo of all the music that inspires and influences me. And this piece is an essential, essence, a deep look into my musical world. So you're gonna actually, the piece goes on kind of a journey, and he says it can be broken up to three different parts. It was dedicated to the trail black music has created, inspired, and the new horizons is reaching. Each part is named after a part of the black identity. Undeniably is the first section. Is the opening of the piece is gritty, intense, with moments of color and undeniable energy. It is carried by a bass line heavily influenced by Thundercats playing on Kendrick Lamar's Untitled 05, along with Miles Davis. Unapologetically, the middle section is a world-building vibe and examines just how beautiful the music can be. I explore the colors and stretch them to their limits, and in doing so found new hues within myself and my writings. The final section is undisputedly an intense, groove-filled statement. Every color explored is here, and it's in its full potential. It's bold, and likely undeniably and unapologetically is undisputedly Black. Guided by my love for Tyler, the Creator's Hot Wind Blows, Marvin Gaye's I Want You, and Kamasi Washington's Street Fighter Moss. So there's a lot of influences in this music, and maybe you'll hear some of those in there. And he says, I hope Dope will serve as a tribute to the Black musicians who have paved the way and inspired me to create music that is authentic to who I am. I also hope that this piece will inspire others to break down the barriers between their musical influences and create something truly unique and personal. And so we hope you really enjoy Dope and kind of jam out to this one with us too.
Thank you. Thank you.